We're going to take a look at length of tangent segments, secant segments, and chords today. So we previously learned that a tangent segment is a segment that touches the circle on one specific spot and only one spot. And a secant and chord are segments that run through the circle and we touch in two different spots. So chord is, in this case we have chords ED and chords AC on our given circle here. Now, it's divided into segments because we end up intersecting at point B. So we have segments AB and BC composing AC, and we have EB and BD making up chord ED. So if we have two chords intersecting a circle, the product of the lengths of the chord segments are equal. So here we have the same circle on our side here. So what this means is if I were to take segment AB and multiply it times segment BC, it's going to be equal to segment EB times segment BD. So all we have to do is multiply, and if we're missing something, then we can figure out what our missing measurement is. So here we have to find our missing variable or values of x. So 1 and 3 are similar, so if we do 1, you're going to be able to do 3. Same with 2 and 4. 2 and 4 are set up the same, so if we can do 2, then we can also do 4 on our own. So if I look at number 1, we have chords AC and ED. And we're told each segment, we have segments 5 and 12 for AC, and we have lengths of X and 10 for ED. So basically, we're going to multiply each section. For AC, we're going to take 5, and we're going to multiply it times 12, and it's going to be equal to the other segment, so X times 10. So we'll multiply 5 times 12, and we get 60, and X times 10 is just 10X. So we're going to divide by 10. And when we do that, we end up with x equals 6. So that's a very straightforward one. We found x in this case. Number 3 is the same way. So it would be 4 times 15 equals 6 times x, and we would solve for x. Now number 2 and number 4 are a little bit different here. Number 2, we have binomials x plus 1 and x plus 8 making up segment PM, and we have the binomial x plus 10 and x making up JL. So we're still going to do the same thing. What we have to do is take each part of chord PM, so x plus 1, times the other part of it, x plus 8, gives me, and then I still do x plus 10 times x. So we have to distribute here, so x times x gives me x squared. X times 8 plus 8x. 1 times x is just x, and then 1 times 8 is just 8. So we distribute on the other side as well. So x times x gives me x squared, and then 10 times x gives me plus 10x. So what we want to do first is we want to combine like terms if we can. So on this side we have 8x plus x, and we end up with x squared plus 9x plus 8. Gives me x squared plus 10x. Now ultimately our goal is to solve for x, so here we're going to subtract x squared from both sides. Because they both have x squared, I can subtract it, and they end up canceling each other out. So x squared minus x squared, x squared minus x squared. So we end up with 9x plus 8 equals 10x. So now we take a look at our setup, and we see we have a straightforward number on the left side, and x is on both. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to leave the number alone. I'm going to subtract 9x. So the 9x's will go away, and we're left with 8, and then 10x minus 9x just gives me 1x. So in this case, we have 8 equals x. So we found our value for x according to our instruction. And we're good there. And we would do the same thing that we just did for number 4. X times x plus 12 equals x plus 6 times x plus 2. And we would solve for x in this scenario. Now, a little definition here, we have a secant segment. It is a segment of a secant line that has exactly one endpoint on the circle. Secant segment that lies on the exterior of the circle is called the exterior secant segment. So here we have two secants. They're lines that happen to run through the circle. And so we have secant AC and secant AE. Now, the way this is going to work is if I have two secants intersecting in the exterior of the circle, so the point of intersection is on the outside of the circle, the product of one secant segment and its external secant segment is equal to the product of the measures of the other secant and its external secant segment. So in order to figure out length, it's very wordy, it's kind of weird in how it sounds, but basically I take the length of the secant. So one secant would be AC, and I have to multiply it times the exterior part of the secant. So the whole thing times the outside. So in this case, the outside is AB, and it is equal to the entire secant, the other entire secant, so it would be AE, times the outside part of that secant, AD. And we can use that to figure out missing values of x, just like we did in the previous one. So the previous one, if the point of two chords on the inside of the circle intersect, we multiply each segment and set them equal to each other. So 5 times 12 is equal to x times 10. In this case, we have secant intersecting on the outside. So we have to use the whole secant times the outside part of the secant is equal to the whole secant times the outside part of the secant. So what does that look like? So here we have to find x. Now we need to know the whole length in order to do that. So here gh is 8 is x, hj is 8. So the outside is x plus 8. And we need to know the full length of LJ, 10 plus 6, 16. So what I do is I will take the whole length of GJ, so we have X plus 8, and we have to multiply it times the outside part of the secant. So the outside part is 8. And is equal to the whole length of the other secant, 16, times the outside part, 6. So we're going to distribute here. X times 8 gives me 8x. 8 times 8 gives me plus 64. And then I'll do 16 times 6, which is 96. So what we'll do now is we're going to solve for x. So subtract 64. We get 8x equals 32. Divide by 8, x equals 4. So that's what we have to do. So the whole length times the outside part equals whole length times outside part. And again, if I look at number 2, I need to know the whole length from RU, so x and 9 is just x plus 9. And I have to do the same for RB, so 4, 5, the whole way is 9. So the equation would be the whole length, x plus 9, times the outside part, x squared, or just x here, is equal to the whole length, 9, times the outside part, 4. So we're going to distribute here. We end up with x squared plus 9x equals, and then 9 times 4 is 36. Now, in order to do this, we'll subtract 36, so we have it equal to 0. So we have x squared plus 9x minus 36 is equal to 0. Because we have a trinomial, we can attempt to factor this. So factor means I break this up into two sets of parentheses equaling 0. So first times first is going to give me x squared. The only way would be x times x. And then we have to come up with numbers that are going to multiply to 36 and add to 9. We'll have to add multiply to negative 36, add to 9. So if I think about 36, we can break down to 36 and 1, 18 times 2, 12 times 3, 9 times 4, or 6 times 6. So we need some combination. We need the two numbers that are going to add to 9. So 36 and 1, no way we can get 9 somehow. 18 and 2, 12 and 3, 12 plus 3 gives me 15, 12 minus 3 gives me 9, so that one would work. 9 and 4 makes 13, 9 minus 4 gives me 5, and then 6 would give me 12 or 0. So we're going to deal with 12 and 3. So again, we have to multiply to negative 36, so that means a positive times a negative. And the question becomes, which number gets which? I take a look at the middle term. Middle term is positive, so the bigger number will get the positive, and the smaller number will get the minus. So plus 12 minus 3. Now, in order to figure out the value of x, we split it up and set each of these equal to 0. So x plus 12 gives me 0. And x minus 3 gives me 0. And I solve for x, so we're going to subtract 12. So we get x equals negative 12. And on the other side, we add 3. And we get x equals 3. So again, it's possible I have two values of x, negative 12 and 3, but the problem is I do have some form of measurement, I do have some space, so I cannot possibly have a length of negative 12. So that is actually not our solution. So I can't have negative 12 on the outside, but I can have an x value of 3. So that is why we're going to pick 3, because I need some form of measurement, and I cannot have a negative measurement value. It's not possible to have a negative measurement. Number 3, again, it's the same thing. I need to know the full length. So x to t, 12 and 7, it's 19. Z to t is x plus 6. And we're going to take the whole length, multiply times the outside part, 7, is equal to the whole length, x plus 6, times the outside part, 6. So 19 times 7, check it out on our calculator, 19 times 7 gives me 133. Distribute, we end up with 6x plus 36. So we're going to subtract 36 because we need to solve for x. We'll end up with 97 equals 6x. And then we're going to divide by 6. I get 16.11111, or 16667. If we try to turn it back into a fraction, we get 97.6. Or 16.1. Repeat. So that is when we have two secants. So the secant, the whole secant times the outside part is equal to the whole secant times the outside part. Now let's say we have a slightly different scenario. Instead of having two secants, I have a tangent and a secant. So what happens here is if I have a tangent and a secant intersecting on the outside of a circle, the square of the tangent is equal to the product of the measures of the secant and the external secant. So notice this time we have JK as our tangent, and then we have JM as our secant. So what this means is I square the tangent, so JK squared is equal to what we were just doing up above. The whole secant, so in this case the whole secant is JM, and I multiply it times the exterior part of the secant, JL. And that's when I have a tangent and a secant. So secant and secant, it's the whole times the outside part equals the whole times the outside part. The tangent and the secant is square the tangent, and it's equal to the whole secant times the exterior part of the secant. So what does it look like with these two problems? Finding x. So here we have the tangent PQ and the secant SQ. So what I have to do is I have to square the tangent. So the tangent is the one that only touches the circle once. So in this case, the tangent is 8, so I have to square it. It is equal to the whole secant, in this case, 12 plus x, times the outside part of the secant x. So we'll square 8, we get 64 equals, and then we'll distribute 12x plus x squared. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to subtract 64 from both sides. So that way there I get a trinomial, and I'm going to put it in order. So x squared comes first, plus 12x minus 64. Now again, what I'm going to try to do is, because I have a trinomial, I can try to factor it. So we end up with 0 equals, and I end up with two sets of parentheses. Now the first two guys will multiply to x squared, so the only possible outcome will be x times x. And then I got to come up with two numbers, multiply 64, add to 12. So if we list off factors of 64, we're talking 64 times 1, 32 times 2, 16 times 4, and 8 times 8. So which of these four could I add to 12? Well, 16 and 4 will make 20, but 16 minus 4 makes the positive 12. So we got a positive 16 minus 4. And again, what I want to do is I want to split them up and set them equal to 0. So 0 equals x plus 16, and 0 equals x minus 4. Solving for x, we'll subtract 16, so we end up with negative 16 equals x. We add 4, so we get 4 equals x. So again, we need some form of positive measurement on the outside. So again, even though we get two answers, negative 16 and 4, the only possible outcome is not the negative 16, because I cannot have a negative value for measurement, but I can have a positive value of measurement, in this case it'd be 4. So that is what we have to do in order to find values of x when it comes to tangent and secant. And I'm going to do the same thing. So in order to do AD, again, I need to know the full length of the secant, so I add x and x plus 4. So 2x plus 4 is the whole way, and then my tangent is 10. So in order to do this, I have to square the tangent. Tangent is 10, so 10 squared equals the whole secant, 2x plus 4, times the outside part, x. And then we go through and solve. So 10 squared is 100. 2x times x is 2x squared. 4 times x is plus 4x. So again, in order to do to make the trinomial, I'll subtract 100. So we have 0 equals 2x squared plus 4x minus 100. Now, the first thing we do is I want to pull off the 2. Everything is divisible by 2. So 0 equals 2 times, and then once I divide everything by 2, we end up with x squared plus 2x minus 50. So what I want to do here is I need to see if there's factors of 50 that will add to 2. In order to be able to factor this as a trinomial. So if I list off factors of 50, we got 50 and 1, 25 times 2, and 10 times 5, and that's all we got. So is there any possible combination here that would add to 2? Short answer is no there is not. So we actually have to use the quadratic formula here in order to figure out values of x. So I'm not going to worry about if I have to figure this out using the quadratic formula. I have to list off factors of a, b, and c. So a is leading number 1, b is on x2, and c is negative 50. So I'm going to plug these into our quadratic formula. X equals negative b plus or minus the square root of b squared minus 40c all over 2a. And fortunately, we can plug these all in. So equals negative value of 2 squared, or negative value of 2, plus or minus the square root of 2 squared, minus 4 times 1 times negative 50, all over 2 times 1. So negative value of 2 is just negative 2, plus or minus the square root. And then I can do it on the calculator. So we have 2 squared minus 4 times 1 times negative 50. And I get 204 all over 2 times 1, which is 2. So because we're adding and subtracting here, I have to do it twice. So here we have negative 2 plus the square root of 204 divided by 2. So we have negative 2 plus the square root of 204 divided by 2. And we get 6.14. And then if I do minus, we have negative 2 minus the square root of 204, and then divide it by 2, we get negative 8.14. So again, we need some form of measurement here. Negative measurements don't really technically exist. So even though we got negative 8.14 as an answer, the only one I can use is the 6.14. And that is using square of a tangent equaling the whole of the secant times the exterior of the secant.